I think so. We both finished at our last class, means in our last class, what we finished. How to calculate the net force acting on a body. Is it or not? Yes. Then, I think you recall it. Then today, our topic is, what is our topic? Force can change us. Force can change us. What? Force can change us. What? What it can change us? Do you can? Huh? I will say different. So already we finished the topic, but I am giving recall. Maybe you forgot. Coming to that, when we are applying force on a body, the body can change. The body can change what? One is motion or rest. That's why I'm saying to you, what? State of a body. State of your body. What I'm saying to you? By applying force on a body, it can change state. It can change state. And second thing, when we are applying force on a body, the body can change. The body can change what? Direction. What is direction? And third one, it can change the shape and size of your body. See there, what I'm saying to you, the applying force on your body, the body can change the state. State means either motion or rest. Either motion or rest. Understand? And it can change the direction of your body. It can change the shape and the size of your body. This is already finished with a different example. Also, yesterday I given one work together, you finished it. Yes, you can. Coming to that, what are the examples to discuss? I will give different situation to you. Different situations to you. Which situation is suitable to this, to change the force to the object? Number one, I am saying to you, I have a much interest to play football. A student said, I have a much interest to play the football. When he is ready to kick the ball, when he is ready to kick the ball, what happens? The ball will move. Means the ball will get the motion. That ball will get the motion. Before where it was, the player to the rest of a ball. Rest of a ball. Means by applying force on the rest of the body changes its state from rest to motion. From rest to motion. At the same time, a person stopped bicycle which is coming towards him. A person stopped bicycle which is coming towards him. See there, the bicycle is in motion. By applying opposite force, the bicycle came to rest. The bicycle came to rest. Understand? See there, what I'm saying to you here, a fielder holds a ball in a cricket match. A fielder holds a ball in a cricket match. Why? Because to stop the ball in opposite direction to apply the force, the ball came from the batsman by hitting before thrown by the bowler towards the batsman. When ball coming from the batsman to the fielder, he must stop the ball by applying opposite direction of force. By applying force by the fielder, the ball came to rest from the motion. Is it or not? At the same time, in the when you are riding bicycle, so before the bicycle is moving, so by pedaling more, the bicycle increases speed. Means before compared to that, by increasing the force, it increases the speed. See there, by applying force on object, what happens? The body can change its state, either rest or motion. If it is in rest, by applying force, it changes to motion. If it is in motion, by applying force, it can come into the rest. Understand what I'm saying to you? The same time, see what I'm saying, if you apply force on a body, the body can change the direction. See there, when you are applying force on a body, the body can change the direction. How the body can change the direction? By applying force. Right now, lockdown, is it or not? So we are at home. Nowadays, we are going by classes. Before the classes, we are very much engaging our time with our playing. First of all, we have much interest to play the carom. What? Carom. Is it or not? Yes, carom. First, we'll talk in the carom. When you are playing the carom, we are giving stroke with the help of striker. To the what? Carom. Not coin. Carom. To the carom. Understand? When you are pushing the striker, means we are applying force to the striker hitting to the rest of the carom. See, before the carom and the striker both are in rest, by giving force, it is changing state. Example for this. Now, by hitting in a particular direction to the carom by striker, the carom changes the direction by hitting the another carom, by hitting the walls of the carom board. Is it or not? Yes. By applying force on your body, the body can change the direction. When you are applying ball to the wall, the ball bounces back in opposite direction. The ball changes the direction by applying force by the wall. Due to the applying force by wall, it changes the direction. When you are playing shuttle or tennis, by hitting in opposite direction, by applying force, the ball means that tennis will change the direction. By applying the force, the body can change the direction. At the same time, the body can change the shape and size. How it can change the shape and size? See there. For that example, we discussed already. Stretching the rubber band. It can change the shape. By stretching, it will become changes the shape. Squeezing the duster, changes shape. Stretching the spring, changing the shape. Means roti chapati with rolling stick. The dough changes the shape and size. When you are stretching or compressing the inflated balloon, the balloon changes the shape and the size. See how many different examples are there in our daily life. Such as, for that I said to collect different examples for different situations. When we are applying force on a particular body, the body, whether it is following or not, to change the body by applying force, to change the rest, motion, direction, shape, and the eyes. Can you gather that information? Yes, we can. Apply for that. Then we'll talk about other effect of force means what is in. Let's discuss one, a concept, small concept. Am I visible to hold to you? If I did not visible to you, I'm saying if we are, we have to stand. Hold should stand now, right now. Right now we have to stand. Right now we have to stand. Do you stand? Yes, very good. This is your hands and these are your legs. These are your legs. This is knee. This is foot. Okay? Knee, foot. Did you stand? Yes. All should stand right now. Who are listening? See that. So this is you. This is your hand. What are those? And these are legs. Legs, legs. Legs. And knees. And foot. So we have to stand with your single leg by stretching another leg to upwards. We have to stretch your leg to upwards. We have to stand by this way. This is one leg. We are standing on single leg. This is knee, no? So the knee, we have to stretch your leg to backwards. We have to stand on single leg right now. Whole should stand on single leg. Do you stand? Then, this, with the help of which foot you stood, that ankle should lift. Ankle should lift. Ankle should lift. You have to lift your ankle. Are you able to stand? By lifting your ankle, are you able to stand? And stand properly and with your two legs. And again, do repeat the activities to stand like and to by changing your ankle. You have to lift your foot, lift your ankle, and then stand normal again. So, which situation is comfortable and sit? Which situation is comfortable? This with your two legs to stand by single leg. To stand by lifting ankle, by stretching other leg to upward. Which situation is suitable and comfortable to stand? Of course, this situation only comfortable to stand with your two legs by placing on ground, on floor. Is it or not? By placing your foot comfortably to downward. And by this, what happens? See, what I'm saying to you, by standing with two legs, you may cover more area. You may cover more area. You may cover more place to stand. See, observe, by standing, you may cover more area. Is it or not? By that, we are not applying more force to stand, to take stability. So we are not applying more water struggle to stand. By lifting one leg, by standing one leg, we struggled somewhat, however maybe, to stand. Means we struggled to apply more force to stand. We take more ability to stay strong. Is it or not? Of course. Means now we are standing by a single foot. That's why we cover lesser area compared to two foot. By that what happened, we plan to apply more force to take the stability. When you are lifting your ankle, what happens? This foot place only standing on the floor means whole weight of you standing with this support only. Means we unable to stand with this, by that to stable, what I am saying, we must stand up with this ankle. For that we struggled to apply more force to take the ability, to take the stability, to take the ability to stand. Is it or not? By this much place, what happened? Here is very less force we applied more to stay, to stand. Is it or not? See here, what happened? When area is decreasing, force is increased more. When area is increased, force is very less we are applying. I understand what is my theme here. Yeah. When you apply, area is, when area is less, force we applied more. If area is more, force we applied less. That is one example. One more we can discuss. What I am saying to one more. Water. Who are carrying their luggage, first they will place big luggage, wide luggage, then after some more less. However, the luggage, how much, whatever the luggage, they will arrange in a water decreasing order to upward. First broad, second broad, third broad, broad lighter. Means what happened? By first increasing area, what, how much you place on that wide surface, that whole weight will be less to apply on us. Because area is more, force will be less. Because of the whole force will be spread out in different directions, not only on our head. Or understand what I'm saying to you? When you are using knife in your home, to cut vegetables, to cut fruits. Are you using knife or not? Otherwise, are you using hands to break the fruits and the vegetables? No more, no? Yes, we are using knife. What you are saying? Knife to cut the fruits and vegetables. There is a two surfaces for the knife. One is a sharp side, one is a blunt side. Sharp side or blunt side. So are you using sharp side or blunt side? Are you using to cut the fruits or vegetables? Which surface you are using? Blunt and sharp. Blunt or sharp. Blunt means a thick. Thick surface. Which is you are not using back surface. That is not. That is a blunt. Okay. Sharp edge you are using, no, smooth surface. By placing another hand after it will. Don't apply. Okay. We have to use only to cut the vegetables and fruits. Understand? Why we are using sharp edge only? Always we are using sharp edge of knife to cut the vegetables and fruits. Why? Because of sharp edge means it contact area is less, so force will be more to easily cut to them. Is it possible? We have to apply, but it will apply less force because wide area. And also we know pressing pen and pencil. And a pencil, the sharpened pencil and the unsharpened size means two sides, sharp size, unsharpened. Okay. First you are placing unsharpened place at the on your palm. This is unsharpened, placing on palm. If you press, not a problem, it never enters to our hand or it never gives a pain to us. Is it or not? Suppose this is a sharp place. If you place, what happens? If you apply force, what happens? Sharper. Sharpened point will enter to our palm. Because of area is less, force will be more. And area is more, force will be less. Why we are using camels in desert? Why we are using camels to travel in desert? Why we are not using horses to desert? horses are not suitable to desert. Only camels are suitable to desert. Why? Because of camels' foot are broad. Camels' foot size are broad than to the horse. That's why broad area of the foot. That's why foot is less. However, the weight. The horse foot is small. So what happened? Foot will be more. So from that, what I'm saying to you from this whole example. How many examples I said to you? From what you understand? What you understand? If the force is more, what you understand? Force is more. What happens? Area is less. If force is less, what happens about area? More. Means force is how like inversely proportional. Force is inversely proportional to the area. Is it or not? Like only we can say how like force means what we are applying on. We are talking about area now. The force is acting on unit area. Force is acting on a unit area. Force is acting on unit area. See what I'm saying to you. This is a vessel. What is this? Vessel. Transparent vessel. I filled water. I took piston. Do you know piston? In syringes, to inject the, what injection? To inject the injection by the syringe. It is syringe consists of backside water piston. Okay, to press, to pull, to push, to pull. Understand? So that piston I'm taking with the same area of the vessel, with the same radius, same diameter. I'm pushing the water to downwards. Pushing water to downwards with using piston. I'm applying force on the whole of the area. How much I'm applying force, it will spread out on unit area of the water. Unit area of the water means how much area consists. A lot I'm applying force, it will spread out equally whole the unit area. Single unit area. Okay. So the force is acting on unit area is nothing as a what is that? Pressure. What is that? Pressure. Pressure is force is acting on a unit area. Unit area. So pressure is showing by symbol is P. Pressure is equal force by area. Force is showing by symbol for yeah. Area is A. Pressure is equal force is measured by Newton in SI system. Area is measured by meter square. Meter square. Because area is equal to what? Side into side. Length into breadth. Side into side or length into breadth. Whatever those. So meter into meter. Meter square. Square of the meter. So what you can say? Pressure is measured by Newton per meter square. Or Newton meter power minus Newton meter power minus 2 what is Pascal? Understand? So Pascal also is unit to measure the pressure because of that will occur. Coming to that, pressure is measured by Pascal or those. Okay. This is general information to talk about what pressure, how it will be. Pressure is directly proportional to the force. Pressure is inversely proportional to the area. If the area is more, pressure is less. If the area is lesser, pressure is more. Understand? Pressure is directly proportional to the force. Pressure is inversely proportional to the area is acting on a body. Okay. Then some more examples you will identify to understand the pressure. We are taking two metal trays. Two metal trays. Okay. See there. I took two metal trays. I filled with this fine sand, smooth sand, otherwise dough. That means powder type substance used to the boat. Okay. I am using two bricks. One is vertically with the same value. One is horizontal. I am dropping two bricks each in each tray, metal tray, which is already filled with the dough. One is vertically, one is horizontal. My question is, which brick will move deep into the two trays? Which brick? I'm giving names for that. This is A and this is B. In which tray, which brick, means which brick, in which tray will move deep? Deep means inside, more inside, depth. Move, more depth. What you can say? According to pressure is inversely proportional to the area. Means pressure is how like pressure? If area is more, pressure is less. If area is less, pressure is what happens? More. Then same as see above, by applying here, if this area is what happens, less pressure will be more. The force applying is more. You see, area is more broad horizontally. Force will be less, means pressure is less. So what happens? Where the more pressure to apply on unit area, it will move very deep. So that's why in the tray here, the brick will move more because of the brick consist area is less, so pressure is more. Understand? So to understand that, one more example for pressure. Okay? There. I'm giving question to you to understand because of already a given one homework. How to find the net force is acting on a body. How to find net force is acting on a body. For that I'm giving because of why I'm giving questions, our lesson was finished first. Okay? Then coming to that. How to calculate net force is acting on a body? How to calculate net force is acting on a body? Then how to calculate net force is acting on a body? Can you see them? I said already how to calculate net force is acting on a body. So this is water. Left side, how much force is acting on the body? Right side, how much force is acting on the body? We have to recognize. So what is the total on this? 10 plus 8 is 18 newton. So right side is 12 newton. So net force is equal to applied force minus opposite force. So net force is equal to applied force, how much? 10 plus 8 newton minus opposite force is 12 newton. Okay. 10 plus 8 newton is 18 newton minus 12 newton. So total difference is 6 newton. So applied force is more, means the object moves towards the right direction. Object moves and object moves towards right direction with 6 newton. With a 6 newton. Like we have to solve. Understand? See, observe this. In this situation, the two arrow marks are showing by this direction. Two arrow marks are showing by this direction. Then, two are showing in the same direction. Then, what is the total force? 8 plus 6 is 14 newton. So, there is only one directional force, is 14 newton. The net force is 14 newton. The object will move towards the right direction with a 14 newton. 14 newton. The same time, that picture, second picture. 8 newton and 8 newton are acting in the opposite direction of the arrow mark. One is from left to right, one is from right to left. Left to right is acting 8 newton. At the same time, right to left also is acting 8 newton on the steel body. So by that, what happened? So applied force and opposite force both are same. The difference of applied and opposite to calculate the net force, 8 minus 8 which will become as 0 newtons. So net force or resultant force on the second body is 0 newton is acting. So 0 newton means there is no force is acting on a body. There is no force is acting on a body. There is no resultant force. There is no net force. Means that body never displaces at anywhere. That body never displaces at anywhere. Means it still it will be where? In rest. The body will in rest. The body will continue as a rest. The body continue as a rest. Coming to this fourth picture. Fourth picture. 9 newton force arrow mark showing upward. 8 newton arrow mark showing downward. So those two arrow marks are in opposite direction. Those two arrow marks are in opposite direction. Then opposite direction, then net force is equal to 9 newton minus 8 newton because applied force minus opposite force. Which is greater, that we are taking applied. Okay. So 9 newton minus 8 newton, difference is 1 newton. So 1 newton resultant is towards upwards. That's why the object will move towards the upside direction with a 1 newton. With a 1 newton. Like we can calculate net force is acting on a body. And also before we discussed the free body diagram. Free body diagram is what we discussed. Two or more forces are acting on a single body. Two or more forces are acting on a single body at a time. Single body at a time. Then you can say that body is nothing as a free body diagram. Free body diagram. That's what they are asking here. Question is, calculate the net force is acting on free body diagram. Net force is acting on free body diagram. Understand? done. What we finished, let me discuss again. So we finished for and push, pull, and contact force, force at a distance, then field, friction, muscular force, gravitational force, and magnetic force. And electrostatic force, and net force, and magnitude. And equilibrium, normal force, and tension, tension, and state of motion. And pressure and free body diagram. Those we learned, those we discussed, and also some more is there, most of we discussed. Huh? See there. Force, push, pull, such a whole we discussed then. Force means what? What we discussed first? Force is a push or pull. Force is a push or pull. It cannot be visible to us. We can feel by action of your body. We can feel by action. Not a body. Sure, not. Force is a push or pull. It has a direction. We can feel by action of a body. It is measured by Newton in SI system, the Einstein system. Already those is discussed. Force can change the force can change the object. So by applying force on a body, it can change the direction. Speed means state, either rest or motion, and direction, shape, and size. Push, when we use the action of push, the body comes closer to us. When you use the action of push, the body comes closer to us. Sorry, push, no. When we use the push, action of push, the body move away from us. When we use the action of push, the body moves away from us. Okay, and pull. So when you apply the action of pull, what happens? The body comes closer to us. And contact force means a direct physical contact force is acting between two interacting objects is known as contact force. For that, we discussed the examples of contact force. What we discussed the muscular force and frictional force, normal force, and what we can discuss the one more. What is the strength of force such like distance? For such a distance, there is no direct physical contact. Force between two interacting objects is known as force such a distance, or field force, or what is non-contact force. Field means area or distance, a part of the distance between objects. And friction. Friction is a force which is acting. The force which is acting opposite direction to the motion of your body. The force which is acting opposite direction of your motion of your body is known as frictional force. It is directly proportional to the normal force. Frictional force is directly proportional to the normal force. Because of the normal force is being balanced to the gravitational force. It always acts upwards direction. How much gravity is acting, that much to balance the force to avoid the falling down. Same as the force of acting on the weight of the body. So that's why. Coming to that muscular force, the force which is exerting by the physical contact of the human being with their muscles by contract and by relaxation. That is the muscular force. Bodies are the force between earth, it always acts downwards to the earth because earth always pulls downwards. Earth always pulls downwards. Gravitational force is a huge force, big force, but I said it is a weakest force. Gravitational force is a weakest force. And the magnetic force, the magnetic force means what is? A force is a repulsion or attraction by the magnetic materials or magnets. The materials which are showing attract or repulsion, okay, is nothing as what a magnetic force. The magnets are exerting a force, attraction or repulsion by the magnetic material, and the magnets is nothing as a magnetic force. And electrostatic force, a force is between the charges of your body. A force between charges of your body is known as electrostatic force. A force between the charged body, uncharged body, or charged bodies. By charged bodies, like poles, like charges will repel each other. Charged body, uncharged body. So unlike charges means unlike poles, like in magnetic poles, so they may attract each other. And net force, the resultant force is acting on a body, on a free body diagram. By applied force and opposite force is nothing else than net force. Due to the net force or resultant force, the body starts to motion or to come to the rest. And magnitude means what? Numerical value. Magnitude means numerical value. And equilibrium means same. Both are in the same, in the constant. When the bodies are in contact, they both are in the same. Equilibrium means same. And normal force, the force which is being balanced to the gravitational force, it always acts upwards direction. Always acts upward direction. So tension, the force which is acting upwards throughout strings, ropes, rods to avoid the gravitational force is the tensional force. State of motion, the body which is said to be in motion, the body should change its position with respect to the surrounding in a given interval of time. And the pressure, the force is acting on unit area. Force is acting on unit area is nothing as what a pressure. Pressure is inversely proportional to the area we discussed already. How like if area is more, pressure is acting less. If area is less, pressure is acting more. So different examples we discussed in those. Free body diagram, FBD. Free body diagram is what the two or more forces are acting on a single body at a time. Simultaneously at a time, then you can say that body is a free body diagram. Free body diagram. Understand? That is the main parameters in our lesson to finish. Or understand our lesson? Those. Okay. Then in our next class, we'll discuss about friction. So this is complete information. If we have any doubt in that, you can post the message to explain again. Okay. So how to calculate the net force exactly on that? Okay, like we can go with those. Understand? At the same time, next we'll go with the friction. About friction, how it will be, whether it is necessary or not. In this whole lesson, different force we discussed. In that next lesson, we will discuss only about friction because it is very essential to us. That's why we'll go with only what about frictional force. So, what I'm saying to you now, leaving the class. See you in the next class. Okay. Good day.